नमस्ते, वेलकम टू द सेशन स्टेबिलिटी एनालिसिस एंड राउथ क्राइटेरिया। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई राउथ क्राइटेरिया एंड एनालाइज द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ सिस्टम। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी हर्विट्स क्राइटेरिया, राउथ क्राइटेरिया, स्टेबिलिटी एनालिसिस यूजिंग राउथ हर्विट्स क्राइटेरिया। The transfer function of any linear closed loop system represented by where B and A are constants. Roots of denominator polynomial of a transfer function are called as poles, and roots of numerator polynomials of a transfer function are called zeros. So to find out closed loop poles, the denominator equation of transfer function, which is also called as characteristic equation of a system, is equated to zero. So here denominator equation a0 s raised to n plus a1 s raised to n minus 1 so on plus n is equated to zero, which is also denoted as f of s. So moving further, just recall Hurwitz criteria by having a pause here. So I think you have recalled Hurwitz criteria. So in Hurwitz criteria, it states that the necessary and sufficient condition to have all roots of the characteristics equation in the left half of the S plane is that the subdeterminant dk, where k 1 to n obtained from Hurwitz determinant H, must all be positive. So we have seen in the last session how Hurwitz determinant H is written from a characteristics equation as given here. So it is written as dk Hurwitz determinant H is written, and then the Hurwitz determinants are calculated as d1, d2, d3, d4 and so on. But there are disadvantages of Hurwitz criteria. For characteristics equation of higher order system, to solve the determinants of higher order is very complicated and time consuming, which we have seen in the last session. And for a system to be stable, number of roots located in right half of S plane cannot be judged by this method. For a system to be marginally stable, it is difficult to predict by Hurwitz criteria. So to overcome the limitations of Hurwitz method, a new method is suggested by mathematician Routh, called Routh's criteria, also known as Routh-Hurwitz criteria. So let us see Routh criteria. Edward John Routh was an English mathematician noted as the outstanding coach of students preparing for the mathematical tripos examination of the University of Cambridge in the middle of 19th century. He also did much to systematize the mathematical theory of machine of mechanics and created several ideas critical to the development of modern control system theory. So Edward Routh has contributed to Routh-Hurwitz criteria. So Routh's criteria, also known as Routh-Hurwitz criteria or Routh's array. Routh suggested a method of arranging the coefficient of characteristics equation in a table. This arrangement is called as Routh's array or Routh's table. Let us write Routh's array or Routh's table. So for a particular characteristics equation, the Routh's table is written as: for first row S raised to n, the coefficients are even coefficients a0, a2, a4, a6. Then for the second row S raised to n minus 1, the coefficients are a1, a3, a5, a7. Then for the row S raised to n minus 1, the b1, b2, b3, b4 are calculated by, b1 is calculated by a1 into a2 minus a0 into a3 divided by a1. Then b2 is calculated by a1 into a4 minus a0 into a5 divided by a1. Then b3 is calculated by a1 into a6 minus a0 into a7 divided by a1. Then let us see how next row is calculated. So here c1 is calculated by b1 into a3 minus a1 into b2 divided by b1. Then c2 is calculated b1 into a5 minus a1 into b3 divided by b1, and c3 is calculated by b1 into a7 minus a1 into b4 divided by b1. So for the next row, d1, d2, d3, d4 are calculated similarly. But what is stability condition by the Routes table or Routes array? So the necessary and sufficient condition for a system to be stable is that all the terms in the first column of Routes array must have same sign. There should not be any sign changes in the first column of Routes array. System is unstable if any sign change occurs in the first column of Routes table. The number of sign changes in the first column indicates number of routes in the right half of the S-plane. Now let us see stability analysis using Routes-Hurwitz criteria. So let us see, for a given equation, is the system stable? So let us find out the coefficients of this characteristics equation. So by observing this equation, we have coefficients as a0 1, a1 8, a2 12, and a3 4. So let us write the Routes array. So here we have S cube. So for the S cube row, the coefficients are a0, a2 as 1, 12, and therefore there is no further element. So we have written 0 here. So for the second row, for S square, the elements are 8 and 4 as a1 and a3. And as there is no further element, so here we have written 0. Then for the next row, S raised to 1. So here we need to calculate the element. So which is nothing but 8 into 12, which is 96, minus 1 into 4 minus 4 divided by 8. So it gives us 11.5. Then next element is calculated by 8 into 0. Minus 1 into 0 divided by 8, so obviously it is 0, and further elements are also 0. So for the next row, S raised to 0, it is calculated by 11.5 into 4 minus 8 into 0 divided by 11.5, which gives us 4. So further elements after calculation will be 0. So this is what Routes-Hurwitz table for the given equation. So you need to calculate the or write the Routes array up to S raised to 0. So from the first column, we have got the values, elements as 1, 8, 11.5 and 4. So if you observe, there is no sign change in the first column. So what you can conclude here is there is no sign change in the first column, so the system is stable. So let us have one more example where we are going to use Routes-Hurwitz criteria for stability analysis. For a given equation, whether the system is stable or not. Here we have a equation 1000 divided by S plus 2 into S plus 3 into S plus 5, which is after calculation we'll get 1000 divided by S raised to 3 plus 10 S square plus 31 S plus 1030. So for this equation, we have the coefficients as a0 1, then a1 10, then a2 31, then a3 1030. For the S cube row, the elements will be 1, 31 and 0. For the second row, S square, we have the elements 10, 1030 and 0. So in the second row, what we can do is we can divide it by 10. So the element for the A square will be 1 and 1, 0, 3 and 0. So for the third row, which is S raised to 1, so 1 into 31 minus 1, 0, 3 divided by 1. So that will give us minus 72. Then next element is 10 into 0, which is 0 minus 0 divided by 10. That will give us 0. So further elements will be 0. So for the row S raised to 0, the values will be calculated by minus 72 into 103 minus 10 into 0 divided by minus 72. So that will give us 103. So we have calculated up to S raised to 0. So if you observe the first column here, the elements are 110, minus 72 and 103. But there is a sign change from the 10 to minus 72. So it is changed from positive to negative. And there is a further one more sign change from minus 72 to the positive 103. So there are two sign changes. So what we can conclude here for this particular question is there are two sign changes. So the system is unstable with two poles in the right half of the S plane. So in this way, we can use Routh-Hurwitz criteria for analyzing the stability of a system. These are references. Thank you.